FARMERMINN friends, how the heck are you? Welcome back to Middleburgh. It is the 20th day of September, this fine and outstanding day. I am planting some barley, getting that in the ground for this fall planting. Winter barley, what a beautiful thing. Got the 4830, I've got my John Deere seeder, got it all filled up as you saw, and we are rocking and rolling. Oh man, absolutely perfect, doesn't get any better than this. Put that up. There we go. Yeah, sorry. Sophie and I were gone. We took a little week vacation, and we went down to see some of the sights here in this beautiful, beautiful valley. Holy crap. Things are good, but I hope you all are doing well. Thanks for tuning in. It is, well, let's see. Let's get you caught up. As you saw, we did, Zeke helped me lime this field, and then, oh, where are you going, Tracker? Where are you going? My GPS is not working all of a sudden. I don't know what the heck is going on here. Come on there, little planner. You got to get back up in line there. Come on. I wouldn't say planner. A little drill here. A little drill press. I don't know why my GPS went off like that. I don't know. Figure it out. I have to have that looked at, I think. There. Down. Okie dokie. Let's try this again. Ah. There we go. Okay, so anyways, as you saw, Zeke came down. That was a while ago. Zeke came down. He got this field limed for me. So we got this field limed. We got this thing fertilized. And then you saw I cultivated it, the big New Holland tractor. And then I had to lease a rock picker-upper thingy. And we got all the stones picked up from the field. So I also sold a shipment of whiskey and corn whiskey. You saw that. So we have $16,000 in the bank minus the 2 pallets of seed that I bought. So, we're sitting pretty good in that department. I need to buy a roller. I got to get a roller so I can roll this field after I get it planted here. So, we want to get the best yield possible. And according to Jacinta B., agronomist extraordinaire, that's what we got to do. So, what Jacinta B. says, we do. We do. But it's a pretty good thing because we'll get this field done and then this will be all good for the coming season. We'll probably have to put some fertilizer on here in the spring and get that all kind of figured up. GPS, you gonna work? Oh, there you are. You're working perfect now. Perfect. So that's kind of where we stand. I still have a little bit more whiskey, corn whiskey, that I could sell, but I don't know how much a roller is going to cost. That's the problem. I don't know how much a darn roller is going to cost, but maybe I can find a bargain somewhere. There's a couple auctions in the area I can go to and get that figured out too. Then, the other thing is, over there on field 7, our corn, we could harvest our corn. So I'm thinking maybe after we get this field planted, we'll get the old combine fired up, the old 7700, and maybe we'll go do some corn harvest and get that down to the mill, and they can produce our cracked corn so we can fill up Holy crap, a little side hill driving here. We can fill up our distillery, and we can keep producing our whiskey, because right now our whiskey is pretty much paying for the farm, to be honest with you. So I don't know where else we can get, you know, we won't have any other production until this coming fall when we harvest our two fields. We do have the grass fields leased up there. So we got to get that going too. We do have a bunch of the straw up in that little hayloft, but I got grass to mow, and I want to get that done before winter flies too, and then we can get that into our fermenting silage, and we can start to make some silage, because I've been having to buy the TMR for our five cows that we have and our chickens. You know, they're going to need some food too, but we do have some wheat in our silo that we can use for the chickens, so that's not too bad. That's going pretty good. Lift that up. There we go. Hopefully my drill press is still working. I haven't gone out to check it yet. I should probably do that. Yeah, let's just jump out here. Let's just jump out, make sure everything's working. It's a pretty good press. Yep, and you can't go wrong with the 4840. Did I say 4830? I meant 4840. So yeah, it's looking pretty good. We're getting the dig down in here, the seeds getting in the ground, so that's working pretty good. So I only got, let's see, all that is done over there and planted. So I have this little section here, which the GPS is running good. When it works, it works. So that's running, so we have that. So, 16,000 bucks in the bank. I got to buy a roller, and then I got to get a mower. So I don't know. Sophie's down at the pub. I think she's drinking down more than she's working. But, you know what she wants now? I'll tell you what. You know what she wants? She wants a lake place. Yep, she wants a lake place. So we were gone on our week vacation. We went and looked at a few. And she thinks it's a great idea that we should buy and invest in a lake place. I don't know. I don't understand sometimes. I mean, Sophie, we got the pub. We got the farm. We don't have time for a stinking lake place. But you know how women are. So I don't know, hopefully I got to figure something out. But that would mean that we'd have to take out an operating loan. Like I said, our operating loan right now is at zero. I like it that way. We're not paying any interest. We don't have a lot of debts. We're kind of self-sufficient with our secret distillery in the woods, which I like. That's nice because I partake in some of that myself down at the pub. So I don't know. It's a, how does that saying go? Damned if you do, damned if you don't kind of thing, you know? Happy wife, happy life. Yeah, so I got to find a mixture of two. So, with that said, I might... I didn't do that turn real well, did I? With that said, I might have to go down to Farm Credit Services and see about getting a little operating loan, because I will need a mower. And there's a nice John Deere mower down to the dealership that I think would be just a cat's little butt and would be kind of nice. So, I don't know. We'll go from there. But in the meantime, what I got to do is finish up this barley. I only have a little bit left. This drill press is working pretty good. The 4840 is working awesome. It's getting dirty. I have to wash this thing. I'll get it washed up when we get done here. And then it'll be I think we'll probably just go do the corn. I think we'll probably harvest the corn and get that done. And then we'll be done with that field. And then I can turn that field around too. Maybe Zeke and Streak is caught up on his farming activities for this fine and outstanding September. I can get him to come and help me a little bit, because then I suppose I'll need to line that too, get that fertilized. I can't plant corn in the fall here, so that won't be planted. That'll be planted in the coming springtime. So we'll have that done in the springtime. So I still have time to get that done, but I should probably get it limed, and then I can get it plowed. And we'll get it ready for the coming year. That'd be a good plan of attack there. Yeah, I like when the GPS is working. Yeah, so I only got like three rounds, and this field will be planted. So we're in pretty good shape. But anyways, let me wrap this up. I'll get back up to the farm. I'll get this drill press put away. I've emptied out the seed, and I'll save that. And get this thing put away, and then probably get the combine fired up. And we'll go do some little corn harvesting, get that out of the way too. It is getting late into the morning here, into the afternoon hour. So bacon sandwiches in order. And a... Mountain Dew, because I can't have canned water now. No, you can't farm and canned water at the same time. Well, you can, depending on what you're doing. But I got too much stuff going on. If I want to get that corn harvested, I gotta be on my toes, you know. Then you can't drive the truck to town with a bunch of canned water. I tell you what, I saw a funny thing the other day. I swear to God, if I see one more person texting and driving, I'm gonna throw my canned water out the window at them. I am. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of the texting and driving people. That's crazy. Anyways, thanks for stopping in. We'll see you in a little bit. I'll get this wrapped up. Yeah, I might have got two more rounds left, and then we're done. And cheers. All right, we got the field all planted with some good winter barley. Now, I did call down to the dealership and double-check. They have a Razol roller down there. That would be perfect for this 4840. And it's about $14,500. So I do have the money in the bank for that. So I said, okay, I'll take it. They're going to deliver that up later on this afternoon. And I'll have to drop by a check to them. So that's a big portion of our bank balance. But Sophie thought that was just a fine idea. $14,500 is not too bad. We can handle that. And we, oh, I got the tractor set out here from my seed. I have two totes of fertilizer over there left over. And the pickup and trailer here for hauling in the corn whiskey and whiskey thing. So we got that taken care of. Let's see, chickens are good. I should check on the cows. Oh, man, I might have to go down and get a load of TMR, but holy crap, I'm only have $1,500 left. But let's get this thing backed in there. I'll have to drain it out here after a while. Or, yeah, they're going to deliver the roller, so I'll wait for that. So I don't need to go down to the dealership and pick that up. They're nice people down there. They'll just bring it up to us, and we can hook up to it that way. And we'll just put this in here. I gotta get some more storage sheds because I really only get the planter and the sprayer in there. But that is what it is. Right, what is unhooked? Pretend I got out and unhooked it. So I'm gonna need this tractor for the roller, so I can just leave it right up here. We'll do that. I should probably get the. You know what I should do? I'm in here and it's all warmed up. I'll get the corn header out of the way. I'll get that pulled out. And the 7700, we can hook onto that, and I can make it through the fence right down there. So then we'll get that. Oh, that's my nice baler and bale wagon. How do you like them apples? Those are nice. Oh, I like that baler and bale wagon. Like I said, I don't have enough storage facility. I really can't store all my equipment anywhere, but yeah, it is what it is. It is what it is. It is what it is. We got the mulcher there. That's looking pretty good. We got the plow. We got the cultivator. Yeah, nice little platform over here. So we'll hook up to the corn header. I'm going to hook up to the header, the right header this time. Remember last time I was hooking up to the wrong header? I think I was doing whatever I was doing. Who knows? But we'll just pull this out. And then I can just leave this tractor right here. And we'll get the combine out of the shed. We'll get that thing fired up. And we'll go get this cornfield done. And I'll get it hauled down to the mill. And they can process my cracked corn for me. And I can use that for my distillery. So let's see. That should be pretty good there. That's kind of cooled down enough. We'll just hop out of the 4840. I had a beautiful tractor. Beautiful tractor. And we'll go see what our shed looks like. Like I said, I have room to put in a building here for more storage, but I don't know. We'll see down the road. Like, I could use that platform over there. I could put a shed in over there, but then I don't have any place to park all my implements. But I wanted to figure out something for the wintertime because I don't want to leave my baler, my bale trailer, and all my stuff outside over the wintertime. I don't like doing that. And then you get rust, you know, it'll look crappy. Yeah, I don't want. I don't want to be the Sanford and Son farmers here. But it is what it is. We'll figure something out. We'll figure something out. Let's see. I suppose I can get the truck out of the way. I feel like I can just bring the truck down there right now. Yeah, I'll bring the truck down there right now, and I'll walk up here. I mean, field 7, the corn is just right down below the hill. So it's not like I got to walk all the way around the countryside. But we'll fire up the old International here. Oh, look at that. That's a beautiful tractor. That's a beautiful tractor. Beautiful truck. I have small stuff. You gonna start? Oh, beautiful. I have small stuff, but it's good stuff. You know what I mean? It's good stuff. Good. There's a guy that I knew back in the days of when Sophie and I were living in Climax, Minnesota. Yeah, actual place. He just always said, good you stuff. Good you stuff there. Yeah, you could understand him half the time, but yeah, COVID got him. Sad deal. COVID got him. But he had some other health issues too, but yeah, he was a good. Oh crap, there's my gate right there. Where in the heck am I going? Let's see. Let's just pull off. I'll just park right here. We'll open the gate. I'll walk up, get the combine hooked up, and we'll get this corn done. Moisture on the corn. Parking brake. There you go. Moisture on the corn is pretty good. So I figure I'm down about 18% moisture, so I can live with that, and that'll be good enough for our cracked corn. But yeah, my header fits right through there. Perfect. Perfect. Yep. Good you stuff there, dear. How you doing there, dear Den? That's what he would always say whenever he saw you. How you doing there, dear Den? Then he would say, what's your name there? After, you know, you just talked to him like 10 minutes ago. Come back, talk to him again. Well, what's your name there, dear Den? I'm like, come on, Keith, you know my name. I've known you for 10 years. But it's just one of those things. Oh, what a beautiful looking farm, isn't it? What a beautiful looking farm. Oh, yeah, I gotta apologize. Sophie and I had to get away for a week. We had a week vacation over the Memorial Day holiday, but yeah, wasn't too bad. We had a storm come through. We lost power for like 28 hours. And when we lose power, we have no water. So that's kind of the crappy thing. So first thing I did the next day, I called somebody that carries those Generac generators, you know, that hook up to your natural gas or propane line that automatically come on. Yeah. I said, that we're doing that. We're doing that. Enough of this crap. We have a little portable one, but the problem with that is that our place, you can't just... you didn't start. Oh, now she's fired up. You can't just start a generator and plug in the whole unit, you know, because you can start it up and run a cord for a refrigerator or whatever, but that would be the cat's meow right there. You just... automatically comes on. Yep. So we spent a lot of time down at the pub that had one. Yep. But that's okay. That's another story. Let's get the 7700 over here. We'll get head out, cooked up our corn header, and we'll get this corn knocked out of the way while Sophie's down at the pub working. I think it's a busy day down there. Holy crap, she called and said the place was packed. So I said, that's awesome. That's what I like to see. Whoa, but Jesus. Holy buckets. There we go. I'm so fast, you didn't even see me get out and hook up the PTO shaft and the cables or anything. Nope. Okay, so all this corn will go down to the mill. We'll get our cracked corn going. So I'm trying to think. I was thinking in my head here as I was driving back up here with the tractor that I'm wondering exactly what I would need to purchase. I got the roller. That's on order. They're going to deliver that. So that's actually paid for with what we have. Holy crap, are you going to fit? I thought you would fit. Ooh, that's tight. Ooh, scratched up against the fence post there. That's not good. Let's see. Let's just find a roll here. I don't know how. Can't remember how I planted this. Let's see. Are you gonna start up? Oh, it did. It did. Let's see. Let's go down this row here. I'll put that nose down that row. There we go. Oh, gotta get over. I'll get this thing opened up, and then I'll see if the GPS in the combine is working. That'll be a lot more... holy crap, look at that. I can barely see over the damn corn. Min of the corn. Holy buckets. That's something else. Seems to be going pretty good. It's coming through the header pretty good. How does our grain tank look? Holy crap, look at that. Some good-looking corn. It's kind of clean, too. Very nice. I did, after I used the combine when I harvested the barley, I did wash it up and I got it all serviced and ready to go turn over for corn. So that's why I could just run in there, fire it up, hook up, and go. So it was all ready to go. I had that all planned out. It's a beautiful thing. You know, field prices are so high lately. I was thinking about that. If I did get some money from Farm Credit Services down there, and I probably, you know, I don't know if they're going to ask for some collateral. Maybe they would ask, like, for the bar to be collateral. I don't want to put up the bar as collateral. I don't want to lose the bar in case farm prices went crap. And you know what I mean? I don't want to take that risk. But I suppose what I could say to them, if they're hesitant in giving me some financing, I could say, you know, I have the distillery. I will put that as collateral. Yeah, that would work. I'm making money off the distillery, and they know that. People are starting to know that now. The word is getting out that I'm making all this money off corn whiskey. So they're thinking, hey, I could do that. I think, no, you can't. No, only I can. You can't do that. I don't need anybody else making whiskey around here and competition-wise. So word's gotten out, but I could probably use that as some kind of collateral if they needed. That would work. Yeah, that would work. But then I was thinking, well, how much money am I going to need? And what do I want to borrow? What do I want to buy? And I don't really need much. I got to get a mower. And then I would need a loading wagon. There's a John Deere self-propelled mower that, oh, man, that was spendy. But that would make life so much easier. Because then I wouldn't have to worry about windrowers. I wouldn't have to worry about stuff like that. I could just get a loading wagon and I could mow it. And then pick it up and put it into my fermenting silo. That would be what I need to do, because then down the road, I'm going to need to get a TMR mixer. I'm going to have to get one of those things to mix all my TMR together for the cows instead of buying it. I'm going broke buying TMR for the cows. And I don't know. You know, I didn't even look to see how much milk I have in my tank, but I could look at that and see if that's something worth selling. Like chickens, they're not laying eggs either. Holy crap, I got like non-laying egg chickens. It's absolutely crazy. But did I just miss some? Did I miss a whole row? I went all the way back and I missed a whole row. Why didn't you say something, for crying out loud? Oh, I'm a terrible corn combine operator dude guy. Oh man, I gotta go back for one row. I was too busy. I was too busy yapping. I didn't even pay attention to where I was driving. I make sure. Oh, that's dumb. That's stupid. This is a stupid game. I don't know why people play it. Holy crap, did that scare the crap out of me. My combine, I got to here. I was combining just fine, and then I was getting full, so I stopped. And my combine wouldn't stop. My pedal got stuck. My combine kept going. Look at that. Drove right through my damn corn. Combine kept going all the way up to the fence. I don't know what the heck is going on. Yep, now I can't. It just, the pedal got stuck, and I couldn't stop the damn thing, and I'm trying to turn it off. It wouldn't turn off, and it went all the way up here to the fence. I had a full hopper. I was going to stop back there, get the truck, empty the combine. I had the GPS working and everything, and the combine wouldn't stop. Thank goodness there's a fence there. Holy crap. I couldn't stop the combine. I couldn't do anything. Brakes wouldn't work. Accelerator was stuck or something. I couldn't even turn it off. So hopefully I didn't do too much damage. I ran into the fence there, but as soon as I hit the fence, I jumped out of that damn thing. So I have a full hopper. So I don't know if my combine is messed up or what's going on here, but well, we'll just empty the hopper and hopefully something will work from there. But that scared the bejeebus out of me. Holy crap. Combine kept going. I'm like, oh my God, I'm gonna die. So we'll see what happens once I get this thing unloaded. I'm hoping it's just like a full hopper kind of glitch thingy, but we'll see. We'll get the international truck here. I'll get this combine unloaded, and hopefully she starts running again. But what I'm going to have to start doing then, because it started acting up at about 75% full. Ooh, 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 combine. See, now it's trying to do its own darn thing there. Holy crap, look at that. I got one of those ghost combines. It's just like it's, I wonder if those invisible tiny people, the Oompa Loompas, are trying to, settle down, combine. Settle down. Calm down. Oh, see, look at it. Look at it. It's trying to move here. See? It's still moving. Stop. Stop, combine. I can't. I don't know. Crazy combine. I don't know. Something's going on here, but, oh, look at that. It's still trying to drive. I am pushing every single button. I'm trying to go backward. I'm trying, yep, it's, I don't know what. Oh, those are sliding to my truck. See, look at me. I'm not even, whoa, no, stop. What in the world, combine, are you, see? Oh, I got turned. No, don't start going out. Oh, you're going to go my fence. Well, I might have a combine for sale. Anybody want to buy a combine? Good, 7,700. I think I figured out what it was, is my GPS. I unplugged my GPS and the combine and started functioning again. So I'm going to have the dealership come up and look at my 7,700 here and figure out why my GPS is making the combine go wackle and start driving itself. So if we can figure that out, in the meantime, I'll just drive by hand. Just drive by hand like the old school days, you know, before all that fancy technology started taking over your machinery. Yep, that's not a big deal. I can do that. I'm just cruising right along here with my fancy-dancy six-row header. One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, eight-row header. I have an eight-row header. I never heard of an eight-row header. Got an eight-row header. Oh, man, I'm a big-time farmer here. But we'll just keep doing this. I'm going to have to make the yield is pretty good on my corn here. So we'll have a couple loads to go down and make some crack corn. You know what I got in my, you know what song I got in my head now, though? That Johnny Crack Corn. Johnny Crack Corn, I don't care. I got that song in my head. I just can't get it out of my head. You know, certain people, and I won't mention any names, mouse. Certain people, they play these jingles. You know, they play these jingles before they go on YouTube or Twitch or anything like that, you know. And they're just stupid. I mean, they're the stupidest jingles. Then they get stuck in your head. Yeah, the other day I had one. How did it go? Let me see if I can think of it. No, that's circus music. That's not it. It'll come to me. It'll come to me. Yeah, stupid jingles, and they get stuck in your head. Yeah, it'll come to me. It'll come to me. But in the meantime, I'm just going to crack away with my corn, my Johnny Crack corn, and I don't care. Oh, what a beautiful day. Then I'm going to call Zeke. I'm going to see if he will lime this field for me. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to lime it. I'll probably put down some urea. Hey, speaking of urea, did you hear that there's like a big urea shortage? Yeah, urea shortage. And then it has to do with a railroad. Yeah, Google this up one time. It was like, I don't know if it's a conspiracy theory or it's all kind of linked together, but something about urea, which is just nitrogen fertilizer, urea, a railroad, and what was the thing? And DEF fluid. Yeah, DEF fluid. Because now they're saying there's going to be a big DEF fluid. And I think it's Flying J. Is it Flying J? Something about urea, Flying J, a railroad, and DEF fluid. Yeah, so, man, could you imagine if there's going to be a DEF fluid shortage? Holy crap. I mean, everything now, you know, none of my stuff here on the farm. Nope. None of my stuff. We don't have any of that fancy diesel exhaust fluid DEF. We don't have any of that. We don't worry about that. But the newer equipment and the new farmers, man, they got all these DEF fluid problems. Holy crap. And there's a shortage of that, and one company controls the market, and something about urea. I don't know. Yeah, it'll be fugly wuggly there, I'll tell you that much. Yes, it will be. Well, let's see. I'm just going to continue going back and forth here, old school driving, because apparently my GPS is high or something on drugs and decides to take over my combine. And then ran into the fence. I bent one of my snouts on my header here. I'll have to see if I can straighten that out later on. But, oh, man, that was scary. That was scary. Ran over my corn, too, for crying out loud. Yeah, the header wasn't even running because I had a full hopper. And, started to run over my corn. I was scared. I literally was scared. Well, let me crack on here with my cracked corn. And I'll see you in a bit. You know what? When I got a song in my head, I can't even get the damn right song. It's not Johnny Crack Corn, it's Jimmy Crack Corn. I don't know what the heck I was thinking. Jimmy Crack Corn. Anyways, speaking of Jimmy Crack Corn, we're cracking on. We're almost done. I got two loads down to the grain mill with my corn that'll be processed into crack corn. And I got just this side of the field. All the rest is done. Oh, crap, don't miss a row. We are cruising right along. It's going pretty good. No GPS, of course. I don't know. That was, as my friend would say, that was bang out of order. That was bang out of order. But it's okay. It's okay. Sophie just called me down at the pub. She says things are busy and wants some help. I said, honey, I'm harvesting some corn right now. I'm thrashing some corn. I don't have time to come down to the pub. Well, how long do you get done? I don't know. Maybe about an hour or so. So once I get this field done, I will have to head down to the pub and give her a hand. Come on, combine. Come on. Come on, combine. Find the row. There you go. Saw a couple deer come running out of my cornfield. I think I am, I should almost leave a strip. I could do some deer hunting here this fall. But I think they'll come in here and they'll eat what's on the ground here. So I'll have plenty of venison in my freezer for the winter, which is pretty good. So two full loads. That's impressive. I'm happy with that. Two full loads of the international truck. So, I have 30,000 liters I got down there already, plus whatever I got in, I got plenty of room in my hopper here to finish this field. Come on. The combine struggles here a little bit up this hill. Come on. Come on, combine. You can do it. Come on. I don't know. Eventually, maybe a bigger combine. But like I said, it's all about the money. Show me the money. Come on. This is painful. Combine, are you spinning the wheels here? There we go. Maybe I should adjust the header height there a little bit. That might help. Yeah, I think I'm dragging on the ground a little bit. I want to be close to the ground because I don't have the implements to really process. I got the plow, but I should have some kind of a roller. Hey, I got a mulcher. That's what I'll do. I'll mulch it. I'll run the mulcher over these corn stalks, and that'll break them up a little bit so I don't have... be easier for planting in the spring. That's what I'll do. I'll run the mulcher over it, and then I'll plow it up. That's what I'll do. There we go. So I have a disc. I have the disc, and that's going to work pretty good on this corn ground. Oopsie-daisy. There we go. There we go. Should be the last pass, and this field is done. I called Zeke. Zeke's going to come up and lime this field for me with his big, fancy spreader. So he'll get it limed for me, and then I can mulch it, and I'll pull it. That's a good plan. That's a good plan. And then in the spring, we'll put some urea down, and we'll cultivate it and be ready to go. Oh, I suppose I'll have to pick up stones then, too, again. Oh man, maybe I could do stones this fall. I could pick up some stones after I plow it this fall. Yeah. Oh yeah, that'll work. That will work. Almost done. Come on, combine. Four more stocks. Come on. There you go. Oh, good job, 7700. You're a fine and outstanding combine. I don't care what the other combines say about you. I think you're a good combine. Turn that up. Whoa, the buckets. There we go. Man, loading auger out. There you go. I wonder how many bushels I have in my combine. Holy crap, combine. I could. I wonder if my chickens will eat corn. Oh crap, look at that. It's falling through my truck. I got a hole in the truck. That's not good. Maybe I'll put this little load into my silo because I do have some leftover from. I have some barley and some wheat in there. Yeah, I could probably just put this corn in there. We'll save that. You know, maybe corn prices go up. We could sell a little bit, make a little extra canned water money. That'll work for me. That will work for me. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. We'll get this thing back up to the shop. I'll get it cleaned up. And I'll do some servicing on there real quick. I won't have to do much, but I'll probably get it switched over to barley. And it'll be good to go. All my corn is still falling through my truck. That's not a good sign. That's not a good sign. Are you empty? Almost empty. Almost empty. There we go. Perfect. Ooh, there we go. Perfect. Get this put the header put back on the trailer. Get the combine washed and put away. Yeah, that wasn't that bad at all, was it? That was not bad at all, except for the little fence driving itself catastrophe that I had. It's my near death. I told Sophie, I had a near death experience in the combine. She said, yeah, you're just kidding. I said, no, seriously, I had a near death experience in the combine. It's absolutely crazy. Absolutely crazy. Well, I'll have to get that auto steer fixed. Maybe I can have the service tech come up here from the dealership and look at my auto steer and see why it's glitching out like that. But that was something else. That was something else. Put it back on the trailer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this back on the trailer. I'm going to get the header put away. I'm going to get the combine cleaned up, and I'm going to get that put away in the back of the shed there for winter. And there you go. Will that work? Yeah, that'll work perfect. Sitting on there nicely. Put this in front of the shed. I'll get it cleaned up. And then I'm going to take that tractor. They're going to bring me my roller. And then next time I see if we'll, I'm just going to set it right here. We'll get it cleaned up and put away. I'll need that tractor yet again, so I don't want to get that thing put away. Let it cool down there. There we go. Yeah, so then they bring up the roller. Then I can go roll that barley field that I got planted. And, I think that was pretty good. I think that was pretty good of a day. We got the barley field planted. We got the corn harvested. Oh, I got the truck. I'll walk down there and get the truck. But other than that, that's not too bad. Next time I see it, I will be rolling that barley field. We'll get that barley field rolled, and that'll be pretty good. Get some stuff cleaned up, and then I don't know what else. Zeke's going to come line. Oh, yeah, then we'll work on that cornfield that we just harvested, and we'll get that squared away for the fall. And I don't know what's going to happen this winter. I really have no idea what's going to happen this winter. I've got a lot to do to get ready for winter, but over the winter, I don't know. I don't know. Besides getting those two grass fields cut, that's kind of what I need to do. I think for next time I'll have an answer on what we're going to do with the egg farm credit services and see if we're going to borrow some money and get that thing taken care of, because I do need to get a mower. I got to get that grass cut before winter. Oh, there's so much to do. There's so much to do. But anyways, we'll leave it there for today. Thanks for stopping in. I sincerely appreciate it. Sorry we were on vacation. It's been so long, but you know what? You got to have one of those once in a while. Yes, you do. Anyway, I put my stand right up there, and the deer will come and eat those two stalks, and I can shoot them right out of that tree. Yeah. If you're a deer lover, sorry, but I'm a deer hunter. Yep, Robert De Niro. I'm telling you, I'm just like Robert De Niro. Anyways, thanks for stopping in. I appreciate it. You guys have a great rest of your Friday. Enjoy the weekend. Be safe. Be healthy, and keep them between the ditches. So long.